Hi guys, and welcome back again to the TechSeek YouTube channel. Today we are going to do a straightforward how-to video with the topic of trying to repair your partially working or completely dead graphics card. In front of me I have the famous NVIDIA's G80 based GPU, the GTS 8800 320MB edition from Asus. A friend of mine asked me for help to figure out what's wrong with it, since one day it just stopped working and the motherboard started to produce this noise when booting up. Sometimes the long beep like this can indicate that GPU isn't getting enough power, or when the PCI Express power connector from the power supply is not connected to the graphics card. After further diagnosis, the graphics card turned out to be the problem, and the first thing that came to my mind is to put it in the oven. Yes, it sounds a bit radical, but this series of graphics cards, like the GTX 8800 or the G92 based GT 8800, were famous for their cold or dry solder joint problem. You can find a bunch of related topics and tutorials on how to fix it, and since I've already done this before, I decided to do a video on it for you. I even had one GTS 8800 from EVGA in my possession for my rig back in 2007, when this card was bang for the buck buy. Before I start, I just want to do a disclaimer, so if you're going to do this on your own, I will not be responsible for the possible damage that you may inflict to your hardware, although when you think about it, the graphics card is already broken, so you don't have anything to lose. The reason why we are putting the graphics card in the oven is that we are trying to melt the cold solder joint and make it conductive again. With this technique, you can basically repair, or at least try it as a last resort, stuff like computer desktop motherboards or laptop motherboards or something like RAM. Before you start doing anything, preheat your oven to 200 Celsius degrees and let it heat up, as it can take a while. Use the grill function like this one on my oven or something similar that directs and puts the heat from above. First you'll have to do is to disassemble the cooler from the graphics card, and when I say all, I really mean all. You can leave the stickers and the metal parts that holds the video outputs. After that, thoroughly clean the old thermal paste and preserve the memory thermal pad so you can use it later on. Take a nice big oven pan and put a sheet of aluminium foil on it. Right away you can also make two aluminium foil balls, so you can level off the graphics card when you put it upside down like this. That's the most usual way of orientating the graphics card in the oven. I've seen some people doing it also the other way, but I prefer it more like this. The only thing left to do now is to put the graphics card into the oven for 10 minutes straight. Use whatever you want for measuring the time, clock oven or smartphone stopwatch. I had better results with other one. I'm just kidding, it doesn't really matter what you use. So after that 10 initial minutes, turn the oven completely off and let it sit for a minute or two with the closed door. The most important part is to cool off the graphics card as gradually as possible, so the solder joints set on nicely. After that, you can slightly open the oven and leave it like that for another 10 minutes. And once that passes, you can completely open the oven for another 15 to 20 minutes. Pulling the card out of the oven, all you need to do now is the reverse process of putting the cooler back on. Of course, apply new thermal paste on the GPU and put everything as it was, in hope that you'll have the same amount of screws that you had while disassembling the graphics card. After you're finished with that, go back to the original place of the crime and install the graphics card into the PCI Express slot, and of course don't forget to plug in the PCI Express power connector from the power supply. And now, the moment of truth, recorded here in real time. As you can see, it seems that we made it as the system is booting up, so success for us. All systems are up and running and the GPU-Z is showing us the usual and normal temperatures for an idling GTX 8800 graphics card. Thank you guys once again for checking out our how-to video on repairing the graphics card. Feel free to give us a thumbs up if you liked this video, leave a comment down below if you have any suggestions in regards of the next how-to video, and of course, if you would like to see more content like this, you can subscribe to our TechSeek YouTube channel, or you can check out our other videos from before.